Coming up, if you develop with open source databases today, we're going to show you the new community-based Postgres and MySQL databases for Azure, including dynamic scale to meet the performance needs of your apps in seconds, high availability that eradicates the need to set up replicas, Azure Service Integration to add intelligence to your apps, as well as how to get up and running while using your existing developer tools and frameworks. Joined today by Sunil Kamath from the Azure Database Engineering team. Welcome.
Thanks for having me on the show.
So Azure's really offered database service options for a while now, but now you can actually use your preferred relational community-based open source database engines in Azure as a managed service.
That's right, and it makes a lot of sense. The goal with Azure has always been to support the need of the developers. As you can see, it's an open platform, and we support any app, platform, or language. We are seeing more and more open source applications leveraging Azure now. Bringing the open source community database engines of Postgres and MySQL to Azure allows us to now continue to support your application development needs, but now as a secure and a fully managed service in the cloud.
And it's really the same platform that's been powering Microsoft SQL Database as a service for many years.
You got it. These services are built on the same proven Microsoft SQL Database Services platform that has been powering the Azure SQL Database Service for many years. We have expanded this platform and brought the same innovations and operational experience to support MySQL and Postgres. Now, it's important to highlight that one of the core priorities in bringing these services was familiarity. You can continue to use your existing tools and frameworks and use any programming languages you're familiar with that supports these database engines. All of this without the need to worry about managing infrastructure or patching or designing for security or high availability. It's all built into the service, backed by an industry-leading 4.9s of availability. You can also flexibly scale compute or storage and scale resources independently.
Plus, you can get more geographic reach of your apps across the entire global footprint of Azure.
That's correct. And your apps can leverage other services in Azure, for example, to build more intelligence into your apps or use the web app services, containers, and more. You can also add intelligence to data.
So how does this work in practice? Is it easy to get started?
Yes, let me show you how you provision your database from scratch. Let's search for MySQL, and you find Azure Database for MySQL. Or by searching Postgres, I find Azure Database for PostgreSQL. Now, to create the database, you then simply have to click on Create the Server. Now, here I am on the portal blade for creating your first Azure Postgres database. Here in this blade, you enter the information such as server name, user credentials, select the region, a pricing tier, and hit create. So here in the connection security, you need to configure the IP addresses for the clients that need to talk to the database. Typically, this is your client IP address. As you can also see, the SSL is already enabled by default. There's an option available also for you to have any Azure services talk to this database without explicitly configuring the IP address. You do this by configuring on for the allow access to Azure services.
And if I'm using a workflow, for example, a web app plus SQL right now, does this also apply if I'm using Postgres or MySQL?
Yes, we have also done the integration of MySQL and Postgres with web apps, so you can deploy these databases as part of your deployment of the app. Here, I've searched for the web app in the Azure portal, and you see the web app plus MySQL and the web app plus PostgreSQL. So here you see the web app plus MySQL deployment workflow, where you can choose the Azure Database for MySQL as the database provider.
Right, and if I wanted to automate my infrastructure provisioning via things like resource manager templates, has that also been built into Azure? Is that using that actually?
Absolutely, this is a common way to build your apps and make the build repeatable. In fact, let me just pull up the template for you. Web App plus Postgres or MySQL uses these templates, and you can look at the JSON file if you want to customize or use this as a basis to build your own template. And let me also tell you that this same template can also be used to automate third-party frameworks like Terraform.
Very cool. So can I use Cloud Shell or the Azure CLI then to talk to Postgres and MySQL?
So as you'd expect from SQL running on Azure, you can manage Postgres or MySQL directly via Cloud Shell or Azure CLI. From the Azure portal, you click on the Cloud Shell icon on the top. MySQL and Postgres client tools are already pre-integrated with the Cloud Shell. Here I'm using a PSQL to connect to my pre-existing Postgres server. And I can also interact with the database using any Postgres or SQL commands.
All right, so what about things like backups or geo-redundancy of your database?
The service has built-in backups with a retention of up to 35 days for point-in-time restore. Backups can also be geographically stored in another region to recover from disasters. In this scenario, you create a server, you select the source from backup, select the geo-redundant backup.
And if I'm already using an open source database on premises, what I need to think through and think about, I guess, as I move from that on premises database to the database as a service model?
The main consideration is the database engine versions we support. Make sure we support the version you're using. The next consideration is the database size, so you know how much storage you need. Then choose the appropriate service tier and the compute you need. It's okay to get this wrong. You can later flexibly scale compute or storage independently.
So how do you go about migrating then an existing database I might be running on-premises into Azure?
You can continue to use your existing tools such as PG dump or MySQL dump to restore or to bring data from anywhere because we are using the same community version of MySQL and PostgreSQL. Mm-hmm. In addition, we have also partnered with Attunity Replicate tool to help customers migrate data to the service with minimal downtime. And this is a free service. Let me tell you how you can do this. I'm in the Attunity Designer and looking to migrate my bookstore to a managed service connected to the local host via PSQL. The first thing I need to do is to set up the migration task. That is, define the source and the target. Let me review the connection properties. I previously entered the connection details for the source, local Postgres, which is my on-premise server. Let us test the connection. Similarly, let us review the connection properties for the target, an Azure database for PostgreSQL. You can see the server name and the connection details. Let us test the connection. We are looking at migrating the bookstore table. Let's look at the source and the target database via PSQL shell now. I want to review how many books titles are in my local database. So for that, I'm executing a query to know how many books I have. You see here, I have about 101 book titles that I want to now migrate to the destination. And here I'm connected to the Azure Postgres service. And obviously, you see that I do not have any of these book titles migrated to the Azure database for Postgres.
Right.
Now we want to move that data with minimal downtime over to the Azure Postgres server. Now let's run our migration task. So now, depending on the size of the data, this could take longer. But most importantly is I do not need to take an outage of my app to move my data to the cloud. Mm-hmm. Now, if I review the book titles on the target, I can see that all the 101 book titles have now migrated successfully to the Azure Postgres service. In summary, I can migrate my existing MySQL or PostgreSQL database to manage Postgres on Azure with minimal downtime. And all it would take now is to change your application connection string and point it to the Azure MySQL or PostgreSQL service.
So now you're in Azure, and this now opens a number of new opportunities also as a developer.
Yes, and the first thing that I want to show is the dynamic scaling. Scale performance, typically you had to think ahead of resources that you need, especially planning for peak periods. Imagine now that our bookstore is becoming very popular and is enjoying strong business success, and you want to add more book titles, you likely want to increase more storage or add storage. Or if there are more users logging into your bookstore during a busy sales season, you may want to increase the compute. Now you can independently scale storage and compute in seconds, allowing you to respond quickly to the changing business needs and therefore optimize your costs.
Right, and beyond scale, really one of the big benefits here is that you can generate insights from your data using things like machine learning or add intelligence to your application via cognitive services.
Yes, on Azure.com, you can see all the cognitive services. I'm interested in adding search capabilities to my app. Specifically, the Bing Web Search API, which gives your app the ability to traverse billions of web documents. For a bookstore, what I want to know is, what does demand for the books in my inventory look like around the world? The API will help me to approximate an answer by getting the number of hits per country for each book. We're now looking at the bookstore app code, where I'm going to add intelligence to this app. In my code, I'm making a call to the Bing Web Search API and storing the results in my Postgres database. Once that insights is available, I can easily visualize via Power BI. Let me show you how. Here I have a Power BI desktop. You click on Get Data, select Postgres database, click Connect, enter the server name and the database name, click OK. Select the search info table and click Load. The search info table has the insights from the Bing Search API. For this demo, I have created a view which represents the hits on each book title across the world. With this information, I can make my app localized and pop up promotional sales in regions where a book is very popular. I could also let the supply chain know that we should purchase more inventory for certain books in a particular region. This is intelligence that I can take action on.
These are all really great insights added to your app. So how can people watching learn more and start trying this for themselves?
You can sign up for the free Azure account today and try the service for yourself. You can also explore more at the link shown below.
So great stuff. Thanks for joining us today, Sunil. And also thank you for watching us on Microsoft Mechanics. Of course, you can stay up to date with all the latest updates across Microsoft by subscribing to our channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.